A truth table is a device used to determine whether a compound statement is true or false. Let's start by looking at the most basic truth table, the negation. So P represents some statement, and that statement can either be true or false. So we list all those possibilities in the truth table for P. If the statement P is true, then its negation must be false. And if the statement P is false, then its negation must be true. I think that first example is a little bit unsatisfying, so let's look at a conjunction truth table. And so we have something concrete to talk about. Let's say that the statement P is dinner includes soup, and the statement Q is dinner includes salad. Now, in the columns for P and Q, we're going to list all of the possible truth values. For example, the statement P could be true, and the statement Q could be true. Another possibility is that P could be true, while Q could be false. P could be false, while Q is true. Or P could be false, and Q could be false. But in this truth table, we really just care about the conjunction of P and Q. This statement P and Q would mean that the dinner includes soup and salad. And that's what we're analyzing in this particular truth table. Let's go row by row. For this first row, what's happening here is we sit down to dinner, and because there's a true here, they bring us soup, and because there's a true here, they bring us salad. So the question is the statement dinner includes soup and salad a true statement? And for this row, the answer is yes, that is a true statement. But let's go to the second row. Here we sit down to dinner, and they bring us soup, but because there's a false here in the Q column, that means they don't bring us salad. So then the question is the statement dinner includes soup and salad true? And it is not, because they did not bring you salad. For the third row, we're not getting soup, but we are getting salad. But still, the statement that dinner includes soup and salad is false. And finally, we sit down to dinner and they don't give us soup and they don't give us salad. So the statement dinner includes soup and salad is false. That is the basic truth table for a conjunction. And you'll notice that our conjunction is only true if both P and Q are true. Let's now look at the basic truth table for a disjunction. First, I'm going to fill out all of the possibilities for P and Q. And now we want to figure out the truth values of this column right here. The statement P or Q means dinner includes soup or salad. So again, in the first row, both P and Q are true, so we sit down to dinner and they bring us both soup and salad. So if the menu says dinner includes soup or salad, have they kept their promise? And the answer is yes. They've gone above and beyond, in fact. In the second row here, P is true and Q is false, meaning they're bringing us soup but not salad. But the menu says that dinner includes soup or salad. Is that a true statement? The answer is yes. They brought us one of the two. The same is true for the next row. Here, they're not bringing us soup, but they are bringing us salad, but the statement is still true. But finally, for this fourth row, we're in a situation where we sit down and they don't bring us soup and they don't bring us salad, so the statement dinner includes soup or salad is not a true statement. So you'll notice that for a disjunction or an or statement, the only way for the statement to be false is if both P and Q are false. Okay, so we've now set up our basic truth tables for our and our or. Let's take a look now at our conditional or our if-then truth table. For this, I've set up a scenario where P is the statement you get an excellent review, Q is the statement you get a raise, then this statement, P then Q, means if you get an excellent review, then you get a raise. So your boss tells you, if you get an excellent review, then you get a raise. Let's analyze the truth of this statement row by row in this truth table. In this first row, you get an excellent review and you get a raise. So that statement that your boss made is true. However, in the second row, it is true that you get an excellent review, but you don't get a raise. That would make this statement above a false statement. For this third row, the situation is you don't get an excellent review, but you do get a raise anyway. Well, your boss hasn't lied, you just got a raise some other way. But the actual statement itself is still a true statement. For this last row, the situation is you don't get an excellent review, but you don't get a raise. Well, your boss has still held up their end of the bargain. They only made the promise of you getting a raise if you get an excellent review. You didn't get an excellent review, so they're not required to give you a raise. So in this situation, this statement is still considered to be a true statement. However, let's now look at the biconditional, or in other words, the if and only if statement. Again, P if and only if Q is the same as Q if and only if P. And either way, we would read this statement as, you get a raise if and only if you get an excellent review. In the previous conditional statement, if you get an excellent review, then you get a raise, we've left open the possibility that you could get a raise some other way. However, with this statement, we don't leave that possibility open. We say that the only way to get a raise is to get an excellent review. And the only way that you would have an excellent review is if you got a raise. So let's create this basic biconditional truth truth table. As always, we're going to put in all of the possible values for P and Q. Let's analyze the truth of this biconditional statement row by row. In the first scenario, you get an excellent review and you get a raise. So the statement, you get a raise if and only if you get an excellent review, is a true statement. In the second row, you get an excellent review but you don't get a raise. That makes this statement a false statement. For the third row, you don't get an excellent review but you do get a raise. Well, that would make this if and only if statement a false statement, because in this case, the only way for you to get a raise is to get an excellent review. In this last scenario, you did not get an excellent review and you did not get a raise. So the statement by your boss here that the only way for you to get a raise is to get an excellent review turned out to be a true statement. So a quick analysis of this conditional and biconditional truth table tells us that the conditional is only false if P is true and Q is false. And a quick analysis of this biconditional truth table is that the biconditional is only true if the value of P and Q match. So now that we've created our basic truth tables for our AND, our OR, our IF-THEN, and our IF and ONLY IF connectives, let's do an example of how we might use these four tables to construct some other truth table. We want to construct a truth table for P or not Q. Notice that this compound statement has an OR in it, so we're going to need our basic truth table for our OR statements. Okay, so we'll keep this over here. Now let's get started with our truth table. I'm going to set this thing up with a few columns. In our first column, we're going to put P. In our second column, we're going to put Q. That's always going to be the case. In our last column, we're going to have P or not Q. That's what we're trying to find the truth values for. In other words, we're going to be comparing our truth values for P with our truth values for not Q. Well, that means that we're going to need our truth values for not Q somewhere in this table so that we can take a look at them. Okay, so I'm going to write down all of the truth values for P and Q as always. Now we have this column not Q that we want to fill out. To do that, we can just look at all of the truth values for Q and switch them. That gives us a column that represents the negation of Q. Now, if we're going to find the truth values for P or not Q, we're going to have to look in this table at the columns for P and not Q. And this is where the basic truth tables that we created earlier in this video pay off. So if we look over here at our truth table row by row, we see in the first row we have a true that we're comparing with a false. We know that true or false gives us a true in this truth table. We know that by looking specifically at this row in this table. Next, we have a true that we're comparing with another true, and we know that true or true is true because of this row in this truth table over here. Now for our third row, we have a false that we're comparing with a false. We know that false or false is false by looking at this last row of this disjunction table. And finally, we have a false that we're comparing with a true. We know that false or true is true because of this row in the disjunction table. So this right here is called our answer column. That was just a really quick example of how we can use the four basic truth tables that we created earlier in this video to create our own truth table. We need to do a whole lot more examples of these, but at least this will get you started. I'll see you next time.